हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन अवर वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन स्ट्रक्चरल एनालिसिस वन. सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर नंबर 9 ऑन मॉड्यूल 3 दैट इज फिक्स्ड बीम, लेट्स कंटिन्यू डिस्कशन ऑन एनालिसिस ऑफ फिक्स्ड बीम. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट स्टैंडर्ड केसेस ऑफ लोडिंग ऑन द फिक्स्ड बीम. Now, what is the aim or objective of this lecture, or what you will get after the completion of this session? So on the completion of this lecture, you would be able to compute reactions at supports and moments for fixed beam subjected to symmetrical loading, okay, and also can draw bending moment and shear force diagram. So first of all, let's have a recap of the points which we have already covered. What we have covered? We have now known about fixed beam as it is rigid at its supports and don't allow any deflection or rotation at its support, and such beams are comes under the statically indeterminate structures, and indeterminacy for such fixed beam subjected to vertical loading is taken as 2. And also we have discussed that steps involved in the construction of shear force and bending moment diagrams. So let's revise it. We were considered that the fixed beam of span L having supports A and B which are fixed. First we have drawn the loading diagram. After that we came to know that there are 4 unknowns, supports at the support reactions and also moments at the support, that is VA, VB, MA and MB. Now to find these 4 unknowns, we have obtained 4 equations. From that 4, 2 equations are basic static equilibrium equation, that is summation of vertical forces equals 0, summation of moments equals to 0, and we have obtained 2 more equations by the and analysis or derivations based on the reflection criteria, that is MA plus MB equals to twice of mu by L, and another equation as MA plus twice of MB equals to 6 times mu x bar divided by L square. So by using these equations, we are now well known about the calculation of the unknowns, and also we were discussed that shear force and bending moment diagram construction and how to draw by using the support reactions. Okay, now in this session let's start our discussion. So in this session we are going to discuss about the third standard case, that is fixed beam of span L subjected to concentric loading or symmetric concentric loading, or we can say the point loads acting at equidistance from the supports. So let us consider a fixed beam of span L. Here L is nothing but equals to 3 times A, or span is divided into 3 equal parts. It is subjected to a point loads W of same magnitude W at a distance of A meters from both the supports. So you can see in the diagram. Now we know that bending moment diagram for fixed beam only considering the vertical downward loading is positive, that is hanging bending moment, and the bending moment diagram by considering only fixed end moment will be the negative, that is hugging bending moment diagram. Now let's draw bending moment diagram by considering individually simply supported beam as a under the vertical loading, and then simply supported beam subjected to end moments. So we by the loading diagram we can draw the bending moment diagram for simply supported beam as a trapezium. So here in this case this trapezium will have the maximum bending moment in between the 2 point loads, that is of magnitude W into A. How it came? Yes, by taking moment on either sides of the section. So if you take moment at these point loads, as both the loads are at equidistance, so W into A will be the moment on both the point loads. So this is the bending moment diagram for a semi-supported beam subjected to two concentrated loads at equidistance. So likewise, we can also draw bending moment diagram for fixed end moments. So as in this case also, the fixed end moments will be equal, that is due to symmetry of loading. So the diagram will be again a simple rectangle, that is MA or MB will be equals. So you can see in the second diagram, and this diagram will be negative bending moment, and the upper one diagram will be of sagging moment or positive bending moment. So likewise, we can draw the individual bending moment diagrams of a semi-supported beam subjected to loading and then subjected to fixed end moments. Now let's discuss one by one how to draw this. So as we know that maximum bending moment for semi-supported condition is W into A, that is force into distance. And by the symmetry we can say that the two fixed end moments MA and MB will be same or equal. So we can say MA equals to MB equals to M. Let's find the area of simply supported bending moment diagram, that is mu or mu diagram. So in our case, mu diagram is a trapezium. You can see in the picture, in figure 2, you can see it's a trapezium. Now you are well known how to find the area of a trapezium. How to find? Yes, area of trapezium will be equals to this base or height divided by 2 into sum of the sides. So in this trapezium, sides are upper side of distance A and lower side of distance 3A. So A plus 3A will be sum of the sides, and height or depth of the trapezium is W into A. So you will get half of W into A in bracket A plus 3A. So by solving, we will get area of semi-supported bending moment diagram or mu will be equals to, yes, twice of W into A square. Now what about the area of fixed end moment diagram? Now in our case, fixed end moment is a simple rectangle. MA and MB are equal, let it be M, and base or span is L. So area of rectangle will be mu dash equals to base into height, that is L into M. So let's rewrite this in the form of A, as mu is in the form of A. So we'll get mu dash equals to M into 3A. Okay, note it down. So likewise, we can find the area of mu diagram and area of mu dash diagram. Okay, now as we know that this mu and mu dash diagram are equal, which we have already discussed in previous sessions. So by equating mu equals to mu dash, we will get twice of W into A square will be equals to M into 3A. Now by solving it, we will get M equals to 2/3 of WA. It is nothing but the fixed end moment. So likewise, we can find moment at the support, that is MA equals to MB equals to M, that is equals to 2/3 of WA. Got it? Note it down. Okay. Now, what about the reactions? We have found two unknowns, MA and MB. Again, there are two unknowns, that is support reactions. So again, due to symmetrical loading, RA will be equals to RB. So total downward load is W plus W, that is twice of W. So half will be taken by support A and half will be taken by support B. So we can say RA equals to RB equals to 2W by 2, that is equals to W. So likewise, we can find the reactions. Now these support moments and support reactions are known to us, so we can go for the construction of shear force and bending moment diagram. Let's go for it. So in our case, this is the loading diagram, fixed beam of span L or 3A subjected to two concentrated point loads. at equidistance, that is A, from the both supports. This will be the bending moment diagram for simply supported beam subjected to only loading, and this will be the bending moment diagram for simply supported beam by only considering fixed end moment, that is MA and MB. As MA or MB both are equal, it will be a rectangle. So by simply merging these two or adding these two, we will get the our actual or final bending moment diagram for the given standard loading condition of a fixed beam. So you can see in this diagram, the net positive bending moment in between W or in between point loads will be, that is total ordinate is WA in figure 1 you can see, and figure 2 we have got MA or MB equals to 2/3 of W. So by simply subtracting the 2/3 of W from WA, we will get the net or maximum positive bending moment as WA by 3 or 1/3 of WA. So we have got maximum positive moment as a 1/3 of WA and maximum negative moment or hugging moment as a 2/3 of WA. These are the very important values. Note it down. Now what about the shear force diagram? So in our case, it is symmetrical loading and both supports have same reactions, and due to end moments, the support reaction will act in reverse direction. Let support A is subjected to negative shear force and support B subjected to positive shear force. So the shear force diagram will be like this. So in this way, we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram. I hope you can draw. Now, in the our final bending moment diagram, you can see there are two points or two points of intersections where positive and negative bending moment diagrams are going to intersect each other. Or we can say at these points, the positive bending moment and negative bending moments, positive bending moment and negative bending moments are changing their nature, or moment is changing from positive to negative or negative to positive. And we know that such points are termed as point of contraflexure. Now, how to find the position of this point of contraflexure, or at which distance this intersection will occur exactly? Let's find. So let us consider a point of contraflexure will occur at distance of x from the support A. You can see in the loading diagram, this is the section of point of contraflexure. So let at this section point of contraflexure occur, which is at a distance of x from support A. So let's take a moment from the x towards A. We will get mx equals to w into x minus m into, or w into x into minus ma. W is the reaction, x is the distance, force into distance is moment, minus end moment, that is hugging moment, minus ma. So likewise, we can take moment at this section. Now again, we know that at this point of contraflexure, moments are zero. Okay, so by simply putting the values and equating it to zero, we will get W into x minus 2/3 of WA will be equals to zero, or by rearranging and solving, we will get x equals to 2/3 of A. So we can say this point of contraflexure will occur at a distance of, yes, 2/3 of that A distance from the support A, and its symmetry will be same from the support B. So in this diagram, you can see these two points where moments are changing their sign are at a distance of 2/3 of A from the both supports A and B. Can you find? Okay, note it down. So likewise, we can also find the position of point of contraflexure. We can point we can mark the exact point of contraflexure. Okay, let's summarize what we have learned. So before summarizing, you should know that in examination or computer examination, it may ask deflection of such type of or such type of loading case. So you should remember that for such type of standard loading case in which two point loads are acting at same distance or equidistance in a fixed beam, then maximum deflection will occur in between point loads, okay, or that is at the center, and its value will be 5 WA³/24EI, 5 WA³/24EI. Got it? Note it down. Let's summarize. So what we have learned in this session? So we have discussed how to find reactions, that is RA, RB, MA and MB, for a fixed beam subjected to symmetrical loading or concentric point loads at equidistance from the supports. So in examination, it may ask some of the questions. So these are the questions based on today's points. You may note it down and try to solve this. Question 1 is, what is the maximum bending moment for a fixed beam subjected to a central point load 80 kN and take span equals to 5 meter? Can you solve? In this case, load is acting at the center, central point load, okay, and span is 5 meter. Draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for a fixed beam of span 6 meter carrying two point loads of 40 kN at a distance of 2 meter from each supports. Here span is of 6 meter, okay, and the point loads are at a distance of 2 meter from the both ends. Let A be the 2 meter and span is the 6 meter. Okay, hope you can solve this. So today we will stop here. In next session, we will learn how to analyze fixed beam again in different such type of standard loading.